Welcome all, this is Saud. Here we have Toyota Corolla ECU. The complaint is injector number 2 not activating. We will take this as good example for troubleshooting practice. I will open the ECU and prepare the full simulation setup. Brief explanation about this setup before we proceed. Here we have the permanent battery power. This one normally directly connected to the ECU as permanent power. This toggle switch is connected to ignition switch input at ECU. So when I switch on this, the main relay will activate and this will provide the B plus power to ECU. And this is what is happening when the ECU is connected to real engine. In fact, here I have 4 set of green LEDs to indicate the status of injectors, and then also we have another 4 red LEDs to indicate the igniters and spark plugs. I am simulating the crank pulse signal from here. This input is very important to get the ECU running. Now let's switch on everything and see what's going on. Yes, that's true. Injector 2 is not getting on, as you can see. Before starting the troubleshooting to fix the fault, I would like to show a very good tip, particularly when simulating Toyota ECUs. Or some other brands if they use the same input. That is the ignition confirmation signal, IGF. Simply, this is a feedback from the coils and igniter controller that the ignition is really taking place and the spark is happening. And the absence of this feedback signal will shut the injectors off. And during the simulation, you will not get the injector outputs unless you simulate this feedback beside the crank and cam signals, of course. I do a simple way to get that. This is, of course, not 100%, but it works with me most of the cases. Otherwise, the alternative way is to get the coils, an ignition control unit, and that's going to make the test on table very bulky and not practical. The idea and circuit is very simple. I will explain it here. We use the same igniter outputs to generate the feedback signals. Every output is passing through a diode to the base of the transistor. The purpose of diode is to allow the positive pulse to go one direction and not returning to the other output circuit. These pulses will happen at different time, and every pulse will get inverted by the transistor because the IGF input, it expects negative pulse, as this input is normally pulled high by the ECU. You can notice when I remove the IGF input, the injectors will shut down. And that is making sense, because what's the point of injecting fuel while it is not getting fired? Now let's try to fix the main problem, which is injector 2 malfunction. This is a multi-layer PCB board, therefore cannot see the copper track and traces, and this is challenging when troubleshooting without schematic diagram and not easy to trace the circuit. But anyway, here I know that the injector drivers should be one of big transistors. Therefore, I just use the continuity tester with multimeter, and I found that this is the injector 2 driver. The big transistor is driven by another two small SMD transistors, this one and this one. So during power off, we check the transistor forward voltage drop and compare it to the other working injector transistors. This is fast way sometime to identify the faulty one, because mostly all following a similar circuit arrangement. Good, the big one is okay. This one looks okay as well. This doesn't look normal at all. The best way now, we switch on again and just trace back the status of the pulses through the driver circuit and all the way to the microcontroller. And this is the advantage of simulating all these signals. We will start from the output pin going down. Okay, here at pin outside, no any pulses from injector number 2. Let's see injector number 1, for example. As you can see, same signals we should expect at injector 2 side. We start now checking the base of big transistor. Nothing here. The first small SMD transistor, also no signals. Let's check at the last SMD transistor. Yes, the signal is available here at the base. but no output from this one. While the supply voltage is reaching this transistor, and as we tested this before during power off, it was abnormal. Therefore, it is clear this is causing the failure. And in fact, up to this point, I can say lucky that the signal is getting out from the microcontroller anyway. Because if the failure from the microcontroller pin, for example, and that is possible sometime, then amount of work is going to be more challengeable. Not only to replace the 120 pin IC, but also copying the program from old microcontroller to new one. So I will just try to replace this transistor and we see the results. You can try to get the same SMD code transistor from another board. Let's switch on everything again after I replaced this transistor. Yes, injector number 2 is working also now. Good. So this ECU can go back to work. That's all. And thanks.